I think this is our session is coming just at the right time. We have discussed secularism and now we are talking about Hindutva. Who is misinterpreting, misrepresenting Hindutva? What is even Hindutva? Let's get started by someone who is a very young Hindutva voice in Parliament now, Tejasvi Surya. You're actually being accused of trying to impose on the country a brand of militant Hindutva.
Thank you, Padmaja, for having me here on this wonderful summit. I think in the opening remarks that you made, you stated we must first understand what Hindutva is. Let me, you know, as briefly as possible, put the very idea of Hindutva, its evolution and its present-day political context. In context so that it will serve as a primer for the discussion. India as a nation was not born on August 15, 1947. India is a continuing civilization with a millennia-old continuity, more than a few thousand years of lived civilizational experience. The primary philosophical thought of India was all-inclusive, all-accepting. It was never exclusivist, and most importantly, it never negated the existence and validity of any other philosophical, spiritual, and religious thought. However, when this land and the philosophies that was born out of this land came in contact with Semitic Abrahamic faiths like Christianity and Islam, which inherently are exclusivist, which inherently are conflicting, predatory, and proselytizing, there needed to be a response by a non-exclusive, inclusive faith, which can be called the commonwealth of Hindu spiritual traditions, to therefore respond to the aggression, the predation, and proselytizing attempts by the Abrahamic faiths that came to Indian soil. A response was made by Indians, by Hindus of that time, and that in the later context was called Hindutva. We can therefore say that if Hinduism is the potential inclusivity of the commonwealth of indigenous thought, Hindutva can be a kinetic effect which primarily is to defend Hindutva, primarily to defend the Hindu philosophy against what is not inclusive, what is primarily exclusive.
So what is this?
Therefore,
what is the need for Hindutva now? What is the threat?
This is the philosophical underpinning of what Hindutva is. Therefore, without understanding the very nature of Hindutva and what it is trying to protect itself against, we will be misinterpreting and misrepresenting the whole debate.
Okay.
Therefore, in that sense, Hindutva is an intellectual, political, social response of the Hindus to prevent itself and themselves against aggression. Therefore, Hindutva cannot be dominating because Hindutva is the victim of aggression. This must be something that must be clarified at the very outset.
Fair enough. But what is the need for that aggressive Hindutva in the 21st century? What is the threat now? We're in a secular democracy. There is no proselytizing. There is no conversion.
No. Let's not jump to those conclusions. When there are evidences contrary to that theory. Hindutva by its very nature cannot be aggressive because the very response of Hindutva emanated to be defensive. Padmaja, what we must in fact be discussing today is why did the Hindus of this land had to come up with an intellectual political response like Hindutva? Because unless we examine and scrutinize the very basis of Abrahamic Semitic faiths, which by their very nature are proselytizing, which by their very nature are predatory, which not just that, by their own nature even go to the extent of negating the existence of other faiths as false faiths, then we must ask questions as to should the Hindu not come up with a response, intellectual, political or otherwise, to preserve and perpetuate himself.
And you need that response today also. In this day and age, in 2020 also you need.
As long as proselytizing religions will continue their existence as proselytizing religions, Hindutva should be there to protect itself, and not just protect itself, but also protect the values that the Hindu society has perpetually held as sacred and sacrosanct.
MBA.
And they, Padmaja, give me 10 more seconds. Those values are in consonance to the modern secular values that the Indian constitution so dearly upholds.
Okay. I